Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss how you can pimp up your task tracker by adding a current status column over here and then making sure that every time the status is updated automatically, the color of that particular row also changes, something like this. This is surely going to make your task tracking much more easier and the tracker visually appealing. So let's just get started with it. Now, for this particular example, I have taken the status sheet of a garage which deals in secondhand cars. So you can see that you have the garage ID, which is like the ID for that particular car, the car make, the car model, maybe the registration number, the status that we're going to add, garage in date. This is basically the date on which the car will be coming into the garage. The service completed date, of course you would want to do the service first, and then a booking date and the dispatch date. So that's how the status looks like, and we're going to update this particular column over here, and at the same time we're going to put some conditional formatting. So first thing first, in this particular tracker what we're going to do is that we're going to make the headers bold. You can freeze this particular cell if you want. So we go to view and then we do freeze panes. You could also choose freeze top row, but if in case your tracker is quite long, you use freeze panes. And when you move over here, you can see that your column as well as rows are frozen so that you can easily scroll from top to bottom or from left to right. So first of all, let's decide what all are going to the various statuses like. So we are saying that as soon as a car arrives into a garage, you're going to put in the garage in date, which essentially means that each and every entry over here should have a garage in date. Let's put any random garage in date over here. Okay, now I have put down some dummy data in garage in date. What I'm essentially trying to say is that as soon as I make an entry here, I have to ensure that the garage in date is there. So as soon as we put the garage in date, it would mean that the car is in service. And after the service has been completed, we will call it inventory. This essentially means that as soon as the service is completed, the car will come into the inventory. Now, if a car is booked, it will come as booked. And then if it's dispatched, it will be sold. Now these are my four different statuses, and I want to put all of these statuses over here in the status section. How can you do it? There are two ways to do it. If you know nested if very well, you can easily put a single nested if condition. But I think for all of you who don't know nested if, let's break it down. Let's break this problem and then try to solve it one by one. Put all those statuses and then combine it to make a nested if function. So how do we look at this particular problem? We'll first of all do one thing, that we'll go on the status from back to front. So the first condition we'll put in is that if the dispatch date here, let me just for now color it. So if dispatch date is filled, irrespective of what the service complete date or booking date is, if dispatch date has been filled, then we say that the car is sold. Let me just put down formula 1, formula 2, and then formula 3. So I can say that equal to, if the dispatch date, which is I2, is not equal to, for not equal to, you'll use less than greater than 0. Then I will put down a sold value, else, let me just leave the false for now. So it's telling me it's false. It's not filled in. Let me put in a date over here. Let's say it's 2 October. So it's sold. So my function is correct. Now, the second one is the booking date. Now, for booking, what I need to consider is two things. One is, of course, that the booking date has to be filled, but the dispatch date has to be blank. In order to do that particular thing, we'll use an if and function. Now we all know that and function is a Boolean function which essentially takes multiple conditions and all of them to be followed or all of them to be correct, then only your answer will be correct. So we'll say that if and booking date is not equal to 0 and dispatch date is equal to 0, then in that particular case it's booked. So it will be equal to if and the booking date, which is H2, is not equal to 0. And the second logic is the dispatch date is equal to 0, like this. If both of these conditions are filled, then we'll say it's booked. And let's not worry about the false value right now. Right, you can see that it is false. Now let's try these two functions. I'll put down a booking date over here. See, for this particular status which is sold, it's giving me a false result. But yes, for booked, it's giving me a booked result. So both of these functions have been correctly put. Now the third one that I want to put is the service complete date. Whatever is service complete date is in my inventory. Now for inventory, what I need to do is that I need to make sure that this one, the service complete date, this is filled, but it has not been booked yet. So for service complete date, we'll put a function equal to if, and the service complete date, which is G2, is not equal to 0. And the second condition would be the booking date, which is your H2 is equal to 0. Both of these conditions are true. In that particular case, it will be my inventory. Let's try it again. Service complete date, I put a date, so it becomes my inventory, and other two functions are false. Now if I put down a booking date over here, it should show me a status of booked, right? And if I put a dispatch date, it should tell me it's sold. Brilliant. Now the last status that we need to check is for in service, and it's pretty simple because we just need to check column G here. If this one is blank, irrespective of the other columns, if this is blank, then it would mean that the car is still in service. So our function over here would be equal to if G2 is equal to 0, comma in service. Right, you can see that here it's showing in service. As soon as I fill a date over here, this becomes inventory. When I fill the booking date, it becomes book. And then the last one is the dispatch date. As soon as I fill this one, it says sold. Now, as I said earlier, that if you know nested if, it's pretty simple to kind of put the entire function together. For those who don't know it, let's do it step by step. We know that we have done four functions over there. Let's combine all of them. So how do we combine it? We first take this fourth condition, copy it from here, put it here in the third one as the false one. Now we take this third one, the entire function, and comma the entire function, and then we take this entire function in 2 and put it as a false value in the first one, like this. Now if you kind of delete all of these, you'll see that we have a single function over here. Let's say I remove the sold, it becomes booked. I remove booked, it becomes inventory, and I remove inventory, it becomes in service. Superb. Now this function, I'll just copy it entirely and paste it in my status column over here, like this. And now I can take this entire thing and paste it in the status column till the end of my tracking sheet, like this. You can now try the various statuses in different columns. Let's say here I want to put the service completed date, I put the booking date, and then I put the dispatch date. You can see here in the status column, with everything changing, this thing is also changing. This is great. Now we have the status in our tracker. This was a very simple example with a simple status, a linear status. You can also have multiple conditions wherein it's not a single assembly line, but your workflow might have multiple conditions coming in, and you can add further conditions over there and then make a big nested function out of that. If you've not understood the nested function properly, I have another video on nested if function, the link for which you can find in the description section below or in the cards at the left hand top corner. Now that you have put in the status, the next thing that we discuss we want to do is put in conditional formatting. What we would want is that every time the status changes over here, the color of my row should also change. Let's first of all decide what are the various colors that you want for your statuses. Let's say in service, you would want something like this blue color. Inventory, you would want a green color, which says, okay, this is an inventory. Booked, you would want a yellow shade, something like this. And sold, a darker color, something like this. So this is what you want different colors to be there. Now let's start doing conditional formatting. What I would recommend is that whenever you're doing conditional formatting, all the different conditions have at least one example over there in the sheet so that you can easily check it. Let's say in this first one, it is in service, we'll leave it like this. This one, we'll put a date. The other one will put two dates, one for the service completed date and the other one for the booking date. And the last one will put all the different dates. So you can see that the first four rows showcase all your different statuses. Now let's start putting conditional formatting. In order to do the conditional formatting, let's first of all do the conditional formatting on the status. So first of all, we'll select the cell, which is E2, that has the status. Go to conditional formatting, new rules. And from style, we'll select classic. And here we'll select only format cells that contain. Now we know that we want in service, so we'll specific text containing in service. Please don't put double quotes over here. It's not a formula or a function. There's no need to put the double quotes. So we'll put in service. And then we need to format it because we want a particular color, customized format. And from here, we'll select that particular blue color. Okay. And okay. Now you can see that this particular status is colored in blue. Now we want to conditional format this particular cell for all the different conditions. Let's set all the different conditional formattings over here and then copy them to the various cells. So we added one for in service. Now let's add one for inventory as well. It will be the same way. We'll go to new rule, classic, and then we'll put inventory. And from here, we'll select customized format, fill, and then we would want a green color, something like this. Okay. Then the third condition, new rule, classic. Third one is booked, and from here the customized format, it would be a shade of yellow color, and okay. And then the last one, new rule, classic, and here we'll put sold, and here we're going to select this particular color, and okay. So we have put all the different conditional formatting for statuses in the first cell. Let's copy it to the first four cells. We just copy the format and paste it on these three cells. Wow, you can see that the format has been copied over here. Now, we would also want that not just this particular cell, but for visual differentiation, we would want the entire row to be in the same color. How will it be done? By conditional formatting, we'll need to add a formula in conditional formatting, wherein we'll say that, okay, this particular cell is going to check for the status here, and if it is in service, it'll change the color to blue, and so on. So let's put the conditional formatting on one cell and then copy it to all the different cells. So let me go to, let's say, garage ID first here, and I'll put conditional formatting, new rule, classic, and here I'll put down the formula is. I will say, since I am in A2, I'll put equal to status, which is E2, is equal to in service, right? And from here, I'll select the customized format, which essentially is the background color, this one. I'll put OK. And wait, just a moment. Now that we know that this conditional formatting has got a function and it needs to be copied to all the different cells, and every time it's referring to the status column, what we are going to do is that we will remove the dollar from the row number so that every time the row changes, it also looks for the same row instead of E2. So we'll remove this dollar and press OK. Now we are done with one particular conditional formatting. Let's add the other three as well. New rule. Here again, we'll put classic, use a formula, and then equal to E2 is equal to inventory. And of course, for inventory, we have a customized format, which is color, this one. Okay. And remember to remove this particular dollar sign. And okay. At the third conditional format, new rule, classic, use a formula, and then equal to E2 is equal to booked. And then the customized format, which is this yellow shade. Yep. And okay. And the last one, conditional formatting, new rule, classic, use a formula, and the formula is equal to E2 is equal to sold. Remove this particular dollar sign, go to customized format, and here you select the color. Okay. And okay. Now what I'm going to do is that since I need the same conditions to be satisfied in all the other columns as well, of course without E2, I'll just copy this particular cell's format and paste it onto BCD. I'll copy it from here and paste it onto these three as well. Oh sorry, this is going to change the format of the date. So I'll go to format and change these back to date. In fact, what we can do is that we can select those date columns, these four date columns, and just change the format to date back again like this. Now simply what I need to do is that I'll need to select the first row in this particular tracker, copy the format of this particular column, and just paste it onto the entire table like this. I might have made a small change in the color. That's why the inventory and in-service is coming with a different color. So you can just take care of it when you're selecting the color. Otherwise, it will look a bit different. Now you can see that not just does putting the dates over here in columns G, H, I change the status, but at the same time, it also changes the color of that particular row. Let's try it with a few examples. Let's say here I'm going to put down a date for service completed date. So it becomes inventory. Now as soon as I put the booking date, the color changes again. And then if I put the dispatch date, it'll change. This is a brilliant way to visualize your data and to share your data with anyone or to share your sheets with people. I'll share a link to this particular sheet in the description below. Go ahead, download it and make changes to it. And if there's anything that you're not understood in this particular video, make sure to write to me in the comment section below. And until next time, bye-bye.
And yes, if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get notified every time a new video is uploaded.